Ganesh Rao. I am honored to be chairman of the Institute of Women Affairs, Telangana State Center. We started the century celebration on 15th onwards. Now with that, this is a century year. In this year, we are 100 years. We are doing a lot of programs, all international conferences and series of all India seminars and roundtable conference, whatever the now emerging subjects are there. Now today, I am very happy that this is a very relevant subject the madam selected. We are also supporting for this type of roundtable conferences. Once again, I am Minister of Engineers. Once again, thanks to all for coming here and welcome to all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Rameshwar Garu. Thank you for allowing us to use your premises. We have always benefited from this partnership. We've done several roundtables and several conferences in partnership with the Institution of Engineers, primarily because they work in the infrastructure space, and you know, engineering is something, it's the backbone of our economy. So, friends, first of all, let me extend my warm greetings to all the doctors present here, journalists of repute, the media representatives from different media houses. I'm really glad that you could take your precious time from busy schedules and participate in something that is really relevant and very, very important. So, a week ago I was in Kuala Lumpur, and the people there inquired about what is happening in Hyderabad, and they got to know the viral diseases that we have, and dengue especially. So I received a call 2 days ago when I was like scheduled to leave for Singapore, and they asked me this question. They said, has your city not declared a health emergency? Just imagine, the city has not declared a health emergency, and you find that there are lakhs of people who are infested with these viral diseases. You seem to have practically one person in every household who either has dengue or any kind of a viral disease. So we both laughingly talked and said that if you were to do a census, you would find, go to every house, you would certainly find someone with this disease. So here, when we conceived this, I was just wondering, there could be two dimensions to managing this. The government has, the first, one of the dimensions is the responsibility of the government. How the government looked at its infrastructure, its provision of services, etc. The other is the medical fraternity. So one is the preventive aspect, the other is the, let's say, the curative and the palliative care that they have to give. But looks like government has thrust the entire responsibility onto the medical fraternity. The government has not done what it is supposed to do. And that, I'll go into the details of that, but looks like the entire onus, responsibility and burden of dealing with this viral and infections and dengue seems to be the entire responsibility of the medical fraternity. And if you see the public health system, we are completely ill-equipped to deal with that. They are not really financially strong either. So now, this being the situation, I'd like to just quickly give four or five very important points from the government side. You as practitioners know how difficult it is to manage this burden, but see from the government side what it is supposed to do. Point one, Hyderabad, they position Hyderabad as a global city. They say that they go and toot and sell Hyderabad as a city of future. But this city apparently doesn't understand that they have to conform to what is called Dhaka Declaration that happened in 2014, when several health ministers from the emerging economies congregated there and arrived at a protocol to manage infectious diseases. They said very categorically that the whole government has to jump into treatment whenever there's an outbreak. It's a whole government that has to jump, not just siloed departments. But Our Hyderabad has not done anything like that. Our government never thought of that. The second thing is, before monsoon, the onset of monsoon, the government is supposed to do simple things like take a check, look at the roads and perhaps fill potholes. That everybody knows. They are supposed to do another thing. They have to go and look for the larvae that are there in puddles of water. That they haven't done at all. And they're called the hot spots. Our minister is very happy with Wi-Fi hot spots. He is not interested in the larvicidal activity where the hot spots are there. So that is the second thing that our people have not done. The third and the important thing is storm water drains. Today, if water is locked everywhere on the roads, why is that happening? From the city infrastructure side, we can categorically say the city needs an additional 450 kilometers of storm water drains. Rameshwar Garu, am I correct? So there has been a technical study and we don't have 450 kilometers of storm water drains which can give comprehensive solution to the water falling and not draining and just becoming breeding grounds for mosquitoes. So that is the infrastructure problem we have. The next thing is what? The next thing is sanitation. Look at the lakes. Today, if you look at the lakes, they have become cesspools. And again, coming to the statistics, why we have this dengue problem is because each of the lakes that gets water, and it has to be treated, the STPs, you know, how many STPs are there, Andy? So we have something like 18 STPs, sewage treatment plants, and they, most of them are defunct. And what is the requirement?
Don't say like
most
that.
Most of them are defunct.
All we are working, madam, don't say. I know very well, with the sewage generating 1600 MLD, we are having the capacity of 750 MLD. Remaining is without the treatment.
How many more are required, you tell
me? The MOSI, that's all. But STP is there, all STPs are working, I am sure. Because I am also in charge for the STP. That's why I am telling. Don't blame the department. Okay. All STPs are good. But the whatever STPs are, it is not sufficient. 50% capacity we are treating, with remaining 50, we are letting into the MOSI. That's all.
So now, one last question to you, because we are discussing STPs and the stormwater drains. What is the requirement for the city? The number.
Also, they are cleaning. Now you can see, in front of our institution also, they are cleaning.
Okay.
But the public awareness is not there. Everybody throwing it is using a dustbin dustbin.
So I'm going
all
to
dust are there dumping into the stormwater drain.
So it is the civic responsibility.
Everybody should feel that. Not only the department, everybody should feel responsibility. Then only that will be maintained as the drains.
Okay. So point taken. Friends, the most important thing is STPs, whether they're working or not, they're completely inadequate. They're inadequate because for the simple reason, you listen to our urban minister, KTR, who took charge recently. He announced that he's going to build 56 more. But technically speaking, I think we need 150. So if such dirty water is going to be let into those lakes, it's going to be polluted and mosquitoes are going to be there. So this is the responsibility of the government. Now let me come to the most important point about water supply. If you know in any of the tropical countries, wherever there's water scarcity, there's breeding of mosquitoes. Now, why is that? In poor tenements, in squatter settlements, there's waterless, intermittent water, so people fill water. My cook every day says that alternate days she gets two hours of water. So she fills water in a bucket, in a vessel, in a small bowl, and she collects wherever possible. And these are the potential breeding grounds for mosquitoes. And if you come to Hyderabad, water supply cannot be so less for the simple reason that we produce 162 LPCD, like 162 liters per capita per day, which is sufficient to give continuous water supply to every household. But somehow we have not managed our water supply well. So that's another problem. And as far as sanitation is concerned, the kind of lifting of garbage, the kind of capping we do, it is a complete public health hazard we have created. Then is there anything else I
tell? Regarding the water supply, we are having sufficient water. Water supply is no problem because almost 610 ml capacity is there, sir. What 600 ml water capacity? Now city is supplying the 450. That only problem is the distribution system is not because of old system. All leakages are there, but water supply everybody are getting water 150 LPCD. That is water supply is everybody. Because of some areas, the where the network is, old network is there, so only we are getting the water supply.
So we don't leakages. Have we don't have universal coverage. I mean, we know that we don't match the benchmarks. So the point is here, we are trying to understand the government deficiencies. We are trying to see how to arrive at solutions. So if we deny that there are problems, then we will not get solutions. So let's...
Madam, not only why I'm telling, because of it is happening, you have to think, but don't blame the system. The system is very good. 1 crore people, they are supplying the water and sewerage. Because funding problem is there, that's why the project is delayed. No. Sewerage treatment plant is not constructed. Already all proposals are there.
Exactly. So funding... Please, I'm not.
I have worked as a director at HMWSSB. 36 years I work in my board. I know that how the board is working.
Yeah.
Don't okay. Because of we need to get water supply. Who is telling me, madam? Everybody are getting water in Hyderabad.
Really?
Really, I'm telling. I'm very proud that everybody are getting water. You compare to Bangalore, Chennai, any country, you can, any state you can see.
No. So, yeah. Exactly. So what I'm saying, please, don't,
What I'm telling.
The reason I did not call government representatives is we'll get into this defensive mode, we'll not get solutions, sir. The idea is we have to get.
You can find out exactly what is the problem and it's better, Gani. And no, sir, because department, I will go and we can talk.
Government is not blaming the department. These are very simple solutions. Solution ante they'll give medical solutions andi manaku avvadu kada avvadu. Okay, so friends, understand that the government has from the government side there are issues which we cannot deny 100%. If funds have stopped, that's why our projects have stopped, but that is a problem also. So from the other side, what is required now is you have to give the perspective from the doctor's perspective, what could potentially be done for this situation? Is there a solution at all readily available for us? And let's brainstorm on that. So I wanted to set the context and very quickly also conclude by saying that Hyderabad, my friends, has never been on the dengue map of India. It has never been there. We had in Madras, we had in Kolkata, we had Lucknow, we had Delhi, but Hyderabad was never on the map of dengue. Now, how come it got on this map? That's because of the problems that we have to have the humility to accept there are problems here, and we need to look at them squarely in the eye, try and solve them. So we have the government infrastructure inputs. We want the medical practitioners. We want people who've been in this ecosystem to give us inputs and see whether we can arrive at some kind of a comprehensive problem. So now thank you for giving me this opportunity to host this roundtable. It's very, very important. People, in fact, they have been so generous that they readily responded to my even text messages, which means it is the need of the hour. So friends, let me throw it open to the doctor fraternity. Let me hear some comments on the current situation and what could potentially be the solutions. So it would be really easy if we can stick to quickly the, you might have seen it up close. There could be some potential problems that have to be addressed straight away. So let's start with the problems and very quickly come to solutions. So Dr. Garu, Vasant Kumar Garu, would you like to start? We'll start with a quick introduction, sir.
Good afternoon, friends. I hope I'm audible. Thank you for having me here. Today, I am here because I am concerned and worried about what's happening in the city of Hyderabad for the last 2 months. My name is Dr. Vasant Kumar. I am a general physician practicing here for the last 40 years. I've been seeing all kinds of acute and chronic diseases from across the social strata. Now the issues, let me immediately come to the some things, and I also want to address some of the controversial issues and give you some facts from the horse's mouth. Let me first tell you, now amongst the viral infections that are going on for the last 2 months here, there are two important viral infections that are attacking most of the people in most of the houses, that is dengue and chikungunya. Both are caused by the mosquito bite, that is Aedes aegypti. I am not going into many details because all of you know. But these two infections are very, very widely prevalent for the last June, from the middle of June. And every year, in fact, we get dengue and chikungunya in most of the places, even in Hyderabad. But it was never so bad, as far as I have seen, in the last 3 decades in the city of Hyderabad, because I belong to the city of Hyderabad. And what is more worrying is we are not accepting what is the problem. If you don't accept the problem, how will you solve the problem? I mean, I have a patient coming to me, sitting in front of me. I am tense and worried. What should I do for a lower middle class patient? What investigation can I ask that patient? Am I justified in asking for an investigation? And how do I go about? Should I admit him, keep him? So a lot of stressful work has to be done to see that the patients are comfortable, they come out of it. So the, now the, coming back to dengue and chikungunya, lakhs of people are suffering from both. The problem with dengue is almost 5 to 10% of them will have low platelet count. Most of them require admission. Even many people here have their family members who suffered. Some of the children are still in the hospital, as I know, one or two of them.
Yeah.
So dengue is so bad. The problem with chikungunya, again, thousands of people are suffering in most of the houses. After the chikungunya attack, they are completely incapacitated with joint pains. Some of them are not able to walk. I have seen people walking with they come to me typically in a wheelchair because they can't get up. The problem is after 1 or 2 weeks, they still have a lot of pains. We can't give them painkillers. And then one more controversial issue that's going on between the government